Esa es la llave. Hace rápido.
You gotta go straight through if you don't have a bag or a purse.
Ay, caramba.
Aquí puedes grabar bien, chicos.
And I am the proud principal of Kamiak High School. In my job, I get to visit classrooms and see students in the process of learning and growing. I have the opportunity to attend concerts and performing arts events. I even get paid to attend sporting events. And I get to do this. My favorite part of the job. I get to be here with all of you today for this important ceremony and the celebration to follow. So,
wow.
Let's get started. Will you please join me in welcoming the Kamiak class of 2022?
Isn't it?
Hey, you gotta leave.
Roll my phone, please. It's already recording. Just get everyone.
Thank you.
celular? Probably.
Thank you.
mi pa son? Saludando a mi papá.
Join me in welcoming the Kamiak staff.
Administrators and staff and school board members, good afternoon and welcome to the Kamiak High School graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. It's been a good minute since we had a full-blown one like this, so let me just say what a beautiful sight it is to see all of you here. My name is Nahom Giles and I had the honor of serving as Kamiak's ASB president for the past 2 years. And let me just say, as I look out amongst all my peers, looking impeccably fly in our purple wizard robes and goofy little square hats, I am filled with immense sense of pride at our accomplishment. Look at us. We're here and we're graduating. Whether you barely scrape by or pass all your classes with flying colors, this is your day and don't you ever forget that. But we could have never made it here without the people who support us along the way. So before I get too ahead of myself, allow me to express the most amount of gratitude to the outstanding Kamiak staff. To my beloved friends for not only their encouragement, but serving as accomplices in classroom shenanigans. And of course, to my wonderful family. Namely, to my sister, whose incessant bullying throughout the years has led me to internalize a multitude of insecurities, but ultimately shaped who I am. And to my dear mother, who has graced me with the wonderful title of favorite child. What a crazy 4 years it has been. We had a normal freshman year, sophomore year cut short, online essentially for all of junior, and well, whatever this year was. But there are so many things to be learned and so many common experiences that we shared that shaped who we are today. For many of us, it was learning the importance of budgeting our time accordingly, not procrastinating, learning which methods of studying are the most beneficial to our own scholastic journeys. That burgers and milk could really hit the spot at 11 a.m. That every day is leg day with how many dang stairs we gotta climb. Don't matter who you are, if you huffing and puffing while you like half asleep trying to get to class, it ain't cute look. Or maybe that it's sink or swim when it comes to Socratic seminars, because some people don't know when to shut up. To play devil's advocate, your turn is up, bud. Now stop jeopardizing the entire class from getting enough points. Or maybe if you compliment the lunch lady's nails, she might give you a little extra pico de gallo on your nachos, you know what I'm saying? On a real note, I want to commend everyone here for the tremendous effort that you brought forth that will enable you to soon walk across the stage and receive your diploma. It hasn't been easy for any of us, let's be real. Before us, back when we were just freshmen in the fall, no one could ever predict the amount of adversity it laid before us back when we were just freshmen. In the following years, some of us had to balance one or two jobs while having heavy and time-consuming coursework. Some of us felt the burning effects of declining mental health and burnout. Some grappled with debilitating TikTok addictions. Whatever the case may be, the work that you put in to get yourself here is nothing short of outstanding. I know a lot of us share the sentiment that we could have done more, done better academically, engaged in more activities and clubs. But the bottom line is, the struggles that our graduating class and our generation as a whole have faced are unlike what came before us. And the fact that we're all here today is a testament to the fact that we all inherently share so much resilience and determination. So please, give yourself a round of applause. As we look towards the future, I'm sure many of us are met with feelings of fear and uncertainty. But best believe, we can take it head on, because the class of 22, built different. Even with everything that we had stacked against us, we're still out here doing the most. Just take a look at the past admission cycle. There's more selective in parts of colleges slimming down their acceptance rates, but also because we got some steep competition to be in this class. There is some real wizards amongst us. I can personally attest to that fact concerning how many waitlists I got put on. At first, I was like, dang, I wish everyone else was a little bit more stupid so I had a better chance. But I soon acknowledged the fact that we got a lot of special people in our midst, and not just academically. We got fantastic singers, producers, filmmakers, designers, actors, musicians, athletes, and so much more. And I know this to be true because I have a mental image of every single one of those roles in my head. And so all my people who haven't figured it out yet, for my people that generally do not know what the future holds in store for them, just breathe and relax. You're not behind all your peers, because to be fair, no one really has it all figured out. And if you feel time is slipping through your fingers, just remember how much went down the past 2 to 3 years. I don't know about y'all, but I feel like an entire decade to me was packed in that little time span. Point of the matter is, you can make a lot happen if you just put your best foot forward and take a chance. And that's not to say it will be easy, but growing up never is. Especially at our young age, you have to acknowledge you have your whole life ahead of you. I'd also like to acknowledge as we cross the threshold into adulthood, and I use that term quite loosely, I know my mom was just on me for the entire past week for not doing no laundry. I'm getting better, sorry. Anyways, as we cross the threshold into adulthood, there'll be a lot of difficult things we have to face. On a personal level, that could be your finances and navigating relationships. But as we look at society as a whole, we can see that at times it can bear an ugly face. And as we shed the shell of childhood naivety, this only becomes more apparent. A wide variety of marginalized groups are disenfranchised and disadvantaged. People from all kinds of backgrounds within our country face all kinds of inequities. It seems as if we are re-traumatized with a new atrocity on a monthly, weekly, daily basis. But what comes with adulthood is also the ability to have your voice heard. Every single year, as people that belong to our generation reach this age, we begin to shape the new American electorate. And the greatest disservice you could be doing to yourself and others is not utilizing your right to express your opinions and vote. Indifference is what drives apathy, and being apathetic is what causes us to lose our humanity. Regardless of your ethnicity, faith, gender identity, and or sexuality, your opinion matters, and the impacts you could potentially have also matters. And never back down from those that oppose you, because when you're used to being in a place of privilege, equality looks like oppression. And coming from a place of privilege, advocate for those who are not as fortunate. We are all such amazing beings who have the capability to accomplish so much, and I hold so much faith in every single one of you. And if I may be candid, the grown-ups have been screwing out for too long, so it's about time that we step up. For some final remarks, I would like to express my gratitude for being chosen to speak at this event. It means the world to me that I was given the honor of having this opportunity. Not only am I referring to speaking here, but having the chance to interact with and share my high school experience with all of you. From the bottom of my heart, thank you all. Also, please never lose sight of what makes you happy. Always remember to engage in things you love and that nurtures your soul, because that's what makes life in this crazy world so worth it. And as a final lesson to y'all, please get better at driving. I cannot tell you how many times I'm driving around the parking lot, I see a hit and run, someone's bumping into a bush. It's just crazy, man. I'm not gonna name names, but we all know who. Rin. Just don't be surprised when I'm driving on the road and I'm swerving to the completely other side of the lane, because I'm not trying to die at 18. Lastly, I'd like to close with a quote from the poet and philosopher, Tyler, the Creator. I want you to leave and go for it. I want you to reach with no fearing, throat clearing, scream it, let him hear it, run it off, baby. Class of 2022, it's been real, and I'll catch y'all at the reunion.
No. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Clap it up for yourselves. Okay, I'm Gunda Wabaluku, and it's an honor to be here with you all today. I've been a speaker with the script, but never a speechwriter. This is the opportunity of preparing that's been eye-opening and different. So when you get a chance to be a student speaker at graduation, you have to take time to shout out everyone who got you here. For staff, Ms. Freeman Miller, Dr. Kuzmani, and Dr. Cabrera, and thank you to the other teachers, counselors, and administration who gave me this opportunity. Thank you. To the family, y'all sitting over there, shout out to y'all. Pemba Buka, my mother, for showing me how to be hardworking and appreciative of what I have. Glody and Glenn, my siblings, for being humorous and giving me space to take a break, to be silly. And Glenn especially, because you've been giving me rides everywhere, and so thank you. And someday I'll give you a car. Not today, but sometime in the future. Dad, I want to thank you for gifting me a childhood full of adventure and new experiences of fun. And to the graduating class of 2022, the pandemic has helped us be able to grow and have a growth mindset that's adapted to change and unexpected circumstances. And COVID, Ms. Rona, has been the most unexpected circumstance in our lifetime, ever. It was cool at first, after going through the routine of school over and over, you know, 7:20, 2 p.m., over and over, over. So when the two-week break was announced, we were all excited to have time to be home and relax. Then we looked at the news and realized our education was never going to be the same. Online school really started our growth mindset because we had to be students and become the teacher. Yeah, we had Zoom classes, but we had the same type of work that comes with six classes. Everything was condensed. 1 year classes were now taught in one semester online. Despite these adversities, we're all sitting here today in our caps and gowns receiving our high school diploma. We have dealt with challenges of living in a worldwide pandemic and are still sitting here receiving a whole diploma. Through difficulty and hardship, we have had to learn that life is not linear. But rather, I know the math teachers right now are about to go crazy. It's like a sine and cosine graph, where there are dips, but there are points where the graph has high points. But nevertheless, like the graph, follows this pattern to infinity. My understanding comes from being a proud first generation student of immigrants from the Democratic Republic of Congo. Shout out to you, Mom. Growing up, I watched my parents getting up early in the morning to work two jobs in order to provide for us. They made sure to take care of us by working hard and giving us the skills to become independent students who could use our passions to inspire change. Observing my parents living paycheck to paycheck has ignited in me to dedicate myself to living a life where I have reign on the trajectory of my career, financials, and health with the guidance of God. I've worked as a student in Leadership Launch, working alongside high school students to learn how to be a better community leader, identify problems, brainstorm how to utilize community resources to address community issues, and implement plans into community-large projects. As former president and secretary of Union for Students of African Ancestry, AKA USA, I have collaborated with the vice president to complete weekly tasks. Through all these experiences, I've worked to seize opportunities to grow my leadership skills. The reality is that we're going to be offered many different positions, but it's crucial for us to choose based on what will benefit the community and cause maturity. Class of 2022, we've taken punches in life and we've gotten back up. We have learned it's important to not forget about ourselves while chasing a bag and achieving monumental goals in the near future. While you progress in your career, do not forget to experience life by exploring the world and learning more about yourself. Though our formative years and childhood are over, we still have life ahead of us. To understand this fully, I'm going to tell you a quote Ms. Freeman Miller has reminded me of many times. People are in your life for a reason, a season, or a lifetime. Those who are around you should be your cheerleader, coach, mentor, and just someone to have fun with. Surround yourself with people who push you to stay ambitious and hungry for what is out there meant to be achieved. Don't let the noise coming from people working against your best interest to consume you into someone you're not meant to be. Despite what's being said and what is going on the world, keep on powering forward. We're sitting here in our caps and gowns, graduating high school, even though 2 out of 4 years of high school were spent at home during a worldwide pandemic. If that's not considered inspirational and aspirational, I don't know what is. As I reflect on time in high school, I want to thank the teachers who have given me the skills to stand in front of you today. Thank you for this opportunity, and just like I said in my yearbook quote, someday you'll see me achieving greatness. Thank you again.
Before I get started with a couple of comments, I do want to take a moment to acknowledge and welcome the people who are with me here on stage this afternoon, starting with the members of our school board, Kyle Kennedy, Charles Howell, John Gehagen, Judy Schwab, our vice president, and Michael Simmons, our president. With us today, we also have two members of our district leadership team, Mr. Pat Hegarty, the Executive Director of Secondary Schools, and our Superintendent, Dr. Allison Brunson. It is also my pleasure to introduce the members of my own administrative team, Mr. Sean Monica, Mrs. Sasha Fraley, Dr. Rosa Cabrera, Dr. Alex Johns, and though he couldn't be with us this afternoon, our Dean of Students, Mr. B.T. Thomas, who's currently in Florida. Big platform, that's okay. He's currently in Florida coaching our Special Olympics Unified Basketball team, which just today earned 5th in the nation. I also want to take a moment to honor our graduation coordinator, Ms. Nina Backeton, and our senior class advisor, Ms. Paige Drafts. When we do get to the part where we're reading names, we have two readers today, Ms. Crystal Stengel and Mr. Duncan. Each year, our students and staff are asked to nominate student speakers for commencement. Thank you, Glenda and Nahom, for your inspirational words today. Clearly, your parents and educators chose well in selecting the two of you to speak today. I believe Glenda and Nahom are examples of something I see in the class of 2022 that I want to talk about briefly today. What I see in our two speakers and in this amazing class are countless sources of light. And that's what I want to talk to you about briefly. As you prepare to cross this stage, collect your diploma, and then head off into life's next grand adventure, I have a challenge for the class of 2022. Shine your light. What do I mean when I say shine your light? When I say shine your light, I echo what Rhea Kim said at the senior breakfast. In her speech, she challenged everyone to use their words for goodness. Each and every one of you has the power to make or break another person's day. You have tremendous power to build or tear down. You have everything you need to bring light to a dark situation with the words you choose to use. By shine your light, I mean share your talents. I'll let you in on a secret. Before the year began, we had no idea what to expect of school spirit. Last spring, Coach Hanukkah joked that you needed to put a mirror underneath students' noses to prove they were breathing. You were so quiet. But you roared back in the fall. You showed up in huge numbers to football games. What a season. You ran and you swam and you bump set spiked to championships all year. Your light was so bright when you were each other's fans in the stands. We fought a losing battle trying to maintain social distancing this year, all year, because your light has a gravity all its own. You are drawn to each other. You make us all so proud with your accomplishments as athletes, and you have left us with a mighty legacy when it comes to school spirit. When I say shine your light, I challenge you to consider what Sam Lewis said in her senior breakfast speech. She told us that it's okay to be uncomfortable. In the great big real world, there are people who will try to convince you that it is your right, that you are entitled to be comfortable. Often those people are trying to sell you something. I'm here to tell you that some of the biggest leaps you will take, some of the biggest gains you will make, will come when you risk being a little uncomfortable. Aim your light into those dark spaces and take a step outside your comfort zone from time to time. One of the darkest spaces during COVID was our Performing Arts Center. There were no spotlights, no microphones, no big chorus numbers. Our musicians and performers had no audiences, no concerts, no standing ovations. Then this senior class came back in a big way. Our concerts were community showcases of talent, thundering applause, sold-out shows, standing room only. You were there to shine your light when you shared your talents. We wondered if you would lead future classes to perform together and take pride in their talents. Your class, the class of 2022, proved that Kamiak's long tradition of performing arts excellence was back. The Starry Night sang a song the other day asking, "Will you take time to miss me?" Yes, we will miss you. We will miss your light. The other day, we heard one of your teachers, Mr. Nettles, share his story. For him, his light is connected to his why. He knows what he is doing. He knows how to do his job and how to get other people to do their jobs. Knowing what to do and how to do it, it's important. Mr. Nettles challenged you to go a bit further. He told you to know why you are doing what you are doing. He warned you that knowing why you are doing something doesn't mean you get to predict what life will be like. But I will tell you, your light burns brightest when what you are doing is rooted in your why. I'm so proud of all of you. What an amazing light you brought to our classrooms this fall. As the leaders of the school, you set the tone for what should be expected of a Kamiak night. Your class has about 480 members. Altogether, you earned 12,189 credits. Someone with a calculator out there is going to divide this number by that and figure out your class went above the required number of credits to earn diplomas today. There are 42 of you who earned 5 years worth of credit in the four years you were with us. Amazingly, as a class, you come from homes where there are 60 different languages spoken. Many of your classmates put their multilingual skills to use and are graduating with 28 or more credits. Among you, there are 257 graduates with a 3.5 GPA or higher. There are 16 of you graduating with perfect 4.0 grade point averages. Your classmates will graduate and head off to all kinds of adventures. We have students committed to colleges and universities locally and all around the world. We have students who earned trade certificates, who will start their apprenticeship or launch straight into their trades. Some of your classmates have chosen to serve our country in one of the armed forces. Thank you for your service. There are some of you who are headed straight into the workforce, well prepared and ready to give your best. I'm so proud of all of you. As learners in the classroom, you have excelled, and that is a light that contributes to your success for many years to come. A moment ago, you heard from Nahom, who shared his light. He's been sharing it all along. Did you see his joy? Your own joy is a light all its own. When you smile, you cause others to smile. You're sharing your light. Joy is a magic ingredient. Yesterday, you heard a similar joy from Jasper Gann. He talked about all you have done to adapt while staying diligent. Jasper's challenge was to reward yourself when you've overcome obstacles. There's joy in that. Indeed, the world needs your youthful joy. Yesterday, at your second senior farewell assembly, Sabrina Kim took her own advice and had some fun with her speech. Do you remember? But she also challenged all of us to focus on gratefulness, being thankful. And we just heard from Glenda. She shared that part of her light, which is a reflection of others. You see, sometimes you are the light, and sometimes you are the mirror reflecting the light shined into the life by others. And that's where I want us to turn our attention, to those who have been sharing their light with you all along. So to do this next part right, I need some help from all of you. Will you please find that little flashlight button on your phone? Can you do that for me? Find that little flashlight button on your phone.
Flashlight.
Here you go. You're figuring it out. All right. Here's what I want to know. Can I see the lights of our proud parents? If you're a parent, hold your light up high. How about grandparents? Where are our grandmas, grandmas, grandpas, aunts and uncles? How about this? Will you please shine your light if you're here celebrating your family's first high school graduate? How about if your family is here celebrating your last high school graduate? We already know Mahone's mom is going to shine her light on this one. Will you please shine your light if you're here celebrating the graduation of your favorite child? We got a couple of brothers and sisters here. How about this? Shine your light if you're one of those proud or jealous siblings. Are you a proud or jealous brother or sister? How about, will you shine your light if you're still trying to figure out how in the world your graduate got to be down here with us today? I know. That there are some sentimental people here thinking about that first day of kindergarten. If you've got a hard time trying to understand how your little baby turned into a kindergartner and now turned into a graduate, will you shine your light? Let's take one moment. I wonder, do we have any of these people's teachers from elementary or middle school here with us today? Are there any middle school or elementary teachers who had these people in their classrooms years ago? I've got a few of you. Thank you. My last one that I want to ask is, are there any former Kamiak students or alumni who sat down here and are now getting to welcome this class into the status of Kamiak alumni? You're so great. Thank you for playing along. Here's my last request. Can I ask one more time, can we have all the lights all at once for the last thing I'm going to say? This is my final challenge to the class of 2022, said one more time. Graduates, going forward into wherever your future takes you, I'm challenging you to shine your light. Thank you, and go Knights.
Celebrating the class of 2022. And graduates, we're super close to giving you your diploma, so hang in there. I have some words of advice. Isn't it great at graduation you get to hear all this advice when really you just want to get your graduate, you know, get your diploma and move on? So we're close, but I have a theme every year at graduations, and my theme this year is called Grit. And it ties in with the other speakers that have gone before me today. So grit is defined as sustained persistence applied towards long-term achievement, and is just as important, and actually some would argue more important, than intelligence. One of my learnings during the pandemic is just how important grit is. Again, it is defined as sustained persistence applied towards long-term achievement. Graduates of 2022, you all have grit. You have proven it by making it here today to walk across the graduation stage and collect your diploma. And you earned it by persisting in a long-term achievement, by successfully completing 13 years of schooling. And as we all know, 2+ of those years was during a pandemic. It is very important as you move on to the next chapter of your life that you realize you have grit. There are 4 characteristics of grit: interest, practice, purpose, and hope. And by improving on these characteristics, you can actually gain more grit. So I'm just going to briefly touch on all 4 characteristics. The first is interest. Enjoy what you are doing. By completing your high school and beyond plan, which I know you all did because it's a graduation requirement, right, Dr. Johns? You had to identify a career pathway that is either a passion of yours or at least an interest of yours. I hate to break it to you, but you're going to be in the workforce for a really long time. So choose something that you love to do. The second characteristic of grit is practice. Embrace new learnings and seek to continuously improve. Set goals. What do you want to achieve? What do you want to be better at? Setting a goal and practicing achieving goals are part of being gritty. You become what you think about most of the time. Third, have purpose. Believe that your work matters. Maybe you do something that betters the environment, helps people, or brings a smile to somebody's face. Whatever it is, know why you are doing it. And finally, the last characteristic is hope. Grit depends on hope that you have the power to improve things. You can make a difference. Thank you for your grit, graduating seniors. I appreciate you, I'm proud of you, and I know you will make a difference. Congratulations. We're getting closer. Trust me, I'd now like to introduce our wonderful school board president, Mr. Mike Simmons.
Thank you, Dr. Burleson, for that introduction. On behalf of the Mukilteo School Board, let me thank you for your continued leadership of our district, for your personal commitment and endless passion for education. It is unparalleled, and for that we are grateful. Let me also thank Principals Heath and Scherzer. Under your leadership, Kamiak High School continues to thrive and prepare our students to be leaders and contributing citizens of tomorrow. Thank you for your invaluable contribution to their future. To the parents, we thank you for your encouragement and support, for trusting us with your children. You are all champions. To the faculty and staff, as always,
Mr. Sherwood, so he should know.
But just wait for him to arrive. No, sir. Pero su mochila. Thank you. Oh, what is that? What are we doing? No, porque aquí, ¿qué pasa? Se sale. Oh, Mr. Shirtlift then. Phone's in it too?
I have my phone number. You have my phone. Everybody has to come out. No, keep going.
Money. Yeah.